The reason I'm so passionate about nutrition is, for me, it is the foundation between that whole holistic health. So what somebody eats, the way somebody eats, that nutrition story will tell you a lot about their overall health. So for me, it opens up a lot more of an individual's well-being, environment, social economic status, and how that's impacting them through their food. When I studied my diploma, my level 4 diploma in nutrition, I had anticipated that I'm going to work with athletes. So really thinking about people running marathons, so because I had some friends that were actually signed up to the London Marathon, and my trajectory completely changed. So now I work with mainly women, a lot of women like myself that are mums, super busy, who struggle with their nutrition on a day-to-day. And a lot more of the food psychology and behavioral coaching comes through in terms of the way in which we eat, so not just the nutrition. So where I thought I was going to go with this and to where I am now is two very different things. I don't think people know enough about nutrition. And that's because there's a lot of mixed messages out there, a lot of misinformation. And if you Google, you are not going to get the best advice. And now we're in an age of social media with influencers, unqualified persons telling people to eat 1,100 calories a day. Very dangerous. So I think as a nation, as a planet Earth, we don't really know much about nutrition. And that's why it's so important to have accredited coaches with the right information to seek advice from. So, having spent most of my own adolescence and adult life in diet culture, mentality, restrictive meal plans, not really understanding macronutrients, this course, the Level 4 Nutrition course, just opened my eyes to evidence-based information, and it was pretty mind-blowing. I can see how people get results from using very unethical practices, but you're not going to be very well mentally. It's going to really compromise you as an individual, and you're probably going to do some long-term damage. So the way that we are undoing diet culture in the nutrition space is by making it very realistic that you're not going to get overnight results in a safe way. You need to have a less is more approach, and we've got to help people quit the all or nothing approach. And look at longer term health and the small actions that get you there. So I might have alluded to it in some of the other work that I've been doing, that nutrition is sometimes only really a surface marker, but it's a very obvious surface marker for a lot of other underlying issues that people face. So I sometimes say that it's the gateway to understanding more deeper issues. And that's where you find people do want to delve into the life coaching aspects. They want more advice around the environmental influences that are impacting their health and their nutrition. So it's really important, alongside nutrition, to look at that whole holistic picture. I have really clear boundaries, right? I'm here for nutrition coaching and as much as the food behaviors that link to that work. But there's always those areas where people either want you to help, and if you're not ethical, you could try to help, and that's, you're overstepping a boundary. So adding on a life coaching course qualification just means that I can handhold that client without having to pass them forward. I can take them on a much fuller journey to understand food triggers and some more of the things that are blocking them from meeting their health goals. So initially, when I began studying the Level 4 in nutrition, it was pretty hectic. I had a full-time job, children starting school, one small child in nursery. But as you know, as you may now know, I then quit the full-time job to pursue this as a full-time career. And since then, it's been a much easier to juggle. But it is about that all or nothing mentality. You've got to come out of that. So for me, if I do not manage and using the tools that I've learned, my own time, then I'm not going to be a really good coach. So for me, it's about understanding about putting my wellness first and looking after my health so that I'm a better support to my clients. I think it's really possible to study and work full time. And I think, again, the way I found studying with Future Fit to be broken down into manageable modules, you've got the tutors to hold your hand. I've made genuine friendships with other students that are actually long lasting now into the third year. We're about to do an actual on stage live event together, in fact. It's asking for the help and knowing that it's there. But also the tutors are really understanding about the life circumstances that might come up. But it's good to have that framework, because when you are studying, you do want to have that momentum and get that qualification within a timely way where you've effectively taken on the learning. So me as an individual, when I signed up to study, I loved the fact that it was online and there were little glimmers of potential in person, but I realised that's part of some courses. But it just saved me from having to add additional travel time to a venue, which when I'm working, I might not have. So I love the online aspect because there is a community, you can find other students, and yeah, if you take that initiative, you can connect with and build your own community as well. I genuinely like the ethics at Future Fit. So as you know, I studied a different qualification initially, which wasn't accredited, and I thought that was really important. If I'm going to be an expert in any field, then I want to be able to be legally compliant, and the ethics behind that are important to be with an accredited provider. And also, you do make it very easy. You have so many different courses. I was actually just laughing about it myself, thinking I might actually go on to Pilates, and it's tempting. Once you're in this field, you want to kind of further your education. I never want to be stagnant. I have to be relevant, not just for myself, for my clients. It's really important. So yeah, Future Fit allows me to keep doing that. I think it's massively important as a health professional in any of those aspects, whether it's fitness and nutrition, to stay on top of your learning. So that continuous learning, the self-improvement aspect, but also the relevance of the information you're giving out. Things change. We're in a really fast-paced world. Things change very quickly. We're seeing new information and data all the time. So being a top of your learning is paramount to being a very good coach or health professional. The most rewarding thing is when I have women who have lost love for cooking. They've gone into a cycle of kind of self-loathing and low self-esteem, find a world without logging their food and counting their calories. They're confident going to the supermarket. They're confident cooking for their families. And they just feel more empowered by choice. And they know that they can slowly improve their health. Like, there's so many things, it's hard to put it into one. It's super rewarding. So I think there is a common misconception that to eat well and live well, you have to spend an arm and a leg. And what I often help with families and individuals, because cooking for one or cooking for a family can come with its challenges, is to utilize things like frozen food, tinned foods, which is quite commonly known, but also understanding what best befores and use-bys are and how you can work around that. So, for example, getting into the supermarket and using marked down goods, like marked down foods, but being able to make like a nice meal prepped, a slow cooker meal, which is going to last you. You can freeze it, you can use it in reek, and you can use it in multiple ways. I love the example of like veggie or vegan chili or even chili con carne. So it's about how to be resourceful with the funds. And again, that's the benefit of working with a professional and us sharing that information, that often things like bread that you can freeze or certain products that you can buy and make them work across the week, it's very possible. So knowing that you're still getting your nutrition, it doesn't have to be, you know, avocados priced at £5. There are ways around, you know, getting the nutritional value at a lower cost. So I think one of the most damaging things that we're seeing are transformation pictures, because you don't really know what the timeline was and you don't actually know how someone's mental health was during that transformation. And so that's the point of being an ethical practitioner, is that you really set a realistic expectation around timelines. This idea of overnight success, which again, huge influencers showing that you can take fat loss pills, meal and appetite suppressants, so dangerous, because I know from doing the work and from doing the studying that a lot of that can backfire and it can really be damaging for someone's long-term health. So a lot of the work I do is getting people out of that mindset and showing them what we call non-scale victories, which you can win on a day-to-day basis. I increased my water intake today. I went for a walk. I spoke to somebody I care about. I feel better overall. I added greens to a meal. There's so many things that outside of a weighing scale are more rewarding than just trying to shrink the quickest possible way. Whilst I love helping people improve the way they eat and live, having that life coaching qualification means I get to help them sustain it from a mindset perspective, from an everyday life perspective, and across all the spectrums of what they're experiencing. And so that relationship doesn't just end at the point they feel confident in eating. And when they resolve what's happening behind the eating, they often, you know, uncover other things that I can support them on that journey, because that relationship is built, and being able to support someone for that much longer term is it's exciting. So I think when it comes to learning and further education and continuous learning, if you have a passion and a reason and a deep reason why you want to do something, you'll often find that motivation. And taking that action then leads to motivation. So it's about knowing that you want to do something, taking a chance, maybe having a conversation with one of the mentors prior, getting yourself into that mindset and looking at that bigger reason why, because that is enough in a lot of cases to push you through. But again, nowadays, home learning is broken down in such an accessible way that once you get that ball rolling, you will see that, and that will increase your confidence. It's the consistency that leads to the confidence.